My name is Melissa Mitchell. I am 22 years old. I am a student of the University of the Commonwealth Caribbean, where I'm pursuing a degree in information technology. I'm very passionate about programming. Well, I love everything IT, but I'm more passionate about programming. When I'm going to school, doing the degree, it's more theory. So it's all about reading to pass an exam. When I actually had to create the prototype, it was just more fun. I heard about this lab through a friend and a lecturer actually. I participated in the hackathon. I think it was a hackathon where I was placed third place. I was doing it alongside my friend. We both did it. We created a prototype. One night I was up all night until about 5 a.m. in the morning trying to complete it. That was when I first realized how much I liked creating prototypes. I entered the pitch in April 2019. I was very nervous. I was very nervous to the point that I didn't want to continue at the first point of it. But as I said, with your encouragement and the rest of the team, I went through. The name of the prototype that I created was Bulwark. I found the name Bulwark in the Bible when they are referring to God. Like, he's my sense of security. He's my bulwark, my fortification. And that's what my app is all about, security for young females. I came up with this idea when I heard of a friend. She got kidnapped on her way from school, actually. She was just leaving class and the taxi took her from the school gate. And she had no way of reaching out, you know? And then it came to me and I realized that what if she had a phone? She could have just sent out an alert immediately just by tapping the power button of their phone twice. And an alert will go out, sending out their direction, what is happening around them, and everybody will know where she at that moment. You know, and that's why I came up with the idea for the app. Yes, and when I got the call and said that I was one of the winners, I was so excited that at first I didn't believe it. I thought you made a mistake calling me. When I heard the others' ideas, I was like, probably my app idea wasn't all that, you know. But when I got the call, I was really very excited. With the money, I bought a phone and I bought a monitor as well to connect to my laptop so I can code easily. After which, I started learning about the softwares. I am now in the programming stage of it, where I'm deciding between PhoneGap and Xamarin to develop the app. But my mentor, she's working alongside me, and at this point, we're in the trial and error stage of it. My advice to anyone who really wants to do something like I did with this app, it's a big step actually, but you can do it. With the help of the lab tech, I was able to learn PhoneGap. The lab tech taught me PhoneGap. And the lab itself is spacious and quite comfortable. Instead of having to be working at school or find a quiet area at school to do the prototype, I actually came to the lab and I could relax, not much noise, sound of any form. And at the lab tech, she was very helpful as well. You know, you don't have to feel nervous or doubtful about your idea, no matter how you think it's not all that. You can actually do it. With one step, you can do it. So the sponsors, Citibank, USAID, Organization of the American States, Trust for the Americas, Institute of Law and Economics, I would like to say a very big thank you for your help and support in providing the funding for the mobile application and also for providing the space in which I was able to relax and work on my application peacefully. I am really very grateful.